Hi everyone and welcome to a new QuickTip by JANUS Engineering. Today I will show you how to get a 5-axis guiding curve operation into roughing, even though it's meant to be for finishing only. My name is Heinrich Flaum and I wish you a lot of fun with today's video. So let's dive right into our scenario for this time. As you see, this part has already been programmed and the last operation is the solid profile 3D operation in here. And you also see that the rest material that is left over has still some stock geometries or stock material on those radius geometries in here left. So how do I get rid of those stock material? First of all, I would like to add a variable axis guiding curve operation on that. We see that the cut area is already defined and also the part stock is set to 0.4 millimeters. But when I generate this toolpath now, we will see that the toolpath actually looks quite well, but as we already know, the stock material that is left over in here is still too much for this little tool in here. So I have to have multiple depths on that. For that, I'm going to strategy and activate the multiple depth cut checkbox in here. I also have to specify a part stock offset. In this case, let's call it like 50 millimeters. So the system knows that there are still 50 millimeters of leftover material in this area. I also have to define the increment. In this case, I would like it to be like 5 millimeters. So let's make the calculation. 15 divided by 5 means 3 depth passes on that. Let's regenerate the operation now. And now we see the results. We now have, as presumed, 3 passes in the depth. But when I make the verification on that, I also will see that I have a lot of air cutting movements up here. As you see, the tool is not cutting material whatsoever. So how can we get the system to cut the material only to, how can we get the operation to cut only in the area where there are still leftovers existing? For this, I'm going to geometry. And now I will activate the in-processed workpiece, or better said, the IPW. So use the 3D IPW for that, and let's regenerate once more. With the new toolpath now, we see that the air cutting time is being reduced by a lot. There are no not unnecessary toolpaths in this region, but only there where there are still part material left over. So let's take a look at the verification now. And now we see that the tool is only driving where there are still material left over. We also can start the NC code based simulation on that to see how the result will look like. For that, I have to activate the machine first. And now I will start the simulation in the NC code context. Let's go. Have you ever had a case where you wanted the operation to behave just as described? Well, with this video, you now have a nice tutorial. By the way, if you want to see more of our videos, we created a nice playlist here on YouTube for you guys. You can find it by clicking on this card or following the link in the description. And if you don't want to miss our future videos, you can start following us here on YouTube by subscribing our channel. Bye.
Let's make it real. JANUS Engineering.